Bonjour, hi! Welcome in another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP based in Montreal in Canada. And today, I want to talk about the Azure DevTest Lab. If you're not using it right now, you're maybe missing something. The DevTest Lab is a service available in Azure that gives us the capability to create small environment where developer will have some freedom and will keep track of the cost by managing what's possible. They are an excellent way to manage the cost and waste because we know we all forget to turn off our VMs, so the DevTest Lab will help us to have a better control. And it's very easy to create. Let me show you. So to create a new DevTest Lab, let's go in the Azure portal. So let's hit that big plus button and we just need to look for DevTest Lab. There it is. So only a few information is required. So you need a unique name, you specify your subscription, of course you use a resource group, you specify a location, you just need create. In a few seconds you will have your DevTest Lab created. Already have one, so let me show you. So here it is, we are in the overview page. And what's nice with the Azure DevTest Lab is that you will have all the resources that are assigned to you in that specific view or in my virtual machines. Right now I have nothing assigned to me, so that's why the page is empty. We all know that when we create a VM, when we click that create button, it takes a little while. And for a developer, it seems an eternity to get that VM available and that we can remote connect to it and start working. So a nice feature that is available in DevTest Lab is that we could create in advance the VMs and make them claimable. So they are waiting for the developer to claim them. And once they claim them, they are assigned and you can right away start working. No waiting. Most of the time when we work with VMs, we work with golden image or just image, a snapshot. We have a specific VM that we built and we have like this specific OS, version of our tools and application pre-install. We do a copy and we use that to make other VMs. But when an update is required on the OS or the tools, then all the VMs are now deprecated because we need to do again our golden image and start over. Another great feature with DevTest Lab is we can still do VMs with image, but we can also use formulas. And formulas, you have like a recipe, a formula where you build your machine. Of course, it's a little bit longer to create, but then, as I said, the machine could be created before the developer needs it. Let me show you. I already create two formula, so let's pick one. Let's, for example, have this Win server. So here in my machine, I already specify the name, the username, I specify that I want to use HDD drive. I specify the size of the VM. And I also specify the artifact. So every time I will be building that machine, the formula will get executed and will go grab the last version of Windows Server 2016, grab and install Visual Studio 2017 with the last update available, and then install Git, Visual Studio Code, and Chrome. This way, I know that every time I create a VM, it will be up to date without any effort from my side. That's really cool. And for the artifact, of course, you could install your own. It will be available in a Git repository, safe, and you will be able to pick them. If you are the guy who managed the DevTest Lab, then the next part will be very interesting. In this option, Configuration and Policies, it's where you will configure everything. And I mean everything. We all know it. We'll always take the bigger VM available. So why not restrict a little bit the size of the VM that are available? So our developer will be able to create VMs, but they will be restricted in the size they will be allowed. That's good. We now have specific size that are restricted or allowed to our developers, but we can also restrict how many VMs one developer can have, or restrict how many VMs in total in our labs is available. That will help the developers to get more responsible and free their resource they're not using. Like I mentioned earlier, it's really nice to have the VM available when we need it, but it's also very important to shut them down when it's not needed. So with those two features, we could build a schedule. Right now, let's say I open auto shutdown. So I will be able to build a general schedule for all my VMs that will shut down every night or during the weekend and boot up automatically if I wish at the morning. Of course, you can have more granularity. You cannot imagine how many takes I did for that word. So like I was saying, you can have more control on your schedule. All the code you will be deploying or the tool that you want to install be part of your formula could be available through repository. They will be defined here. They could be public or they could be private. All the secret to connect in a Git repository could be saved in the secret area of the DevTest lab. So that way you could use the secrets without knowing them. So that's pretty cool. Of course, many other features are available, but I won't pass through all of them. Just want to give you a good overview. You can still do your custom image. No problem with that. It's just that the formula are really powerful if, for example, you're doing more tests than dev. Or it's really useful when you use specific image for clients. So if the clients has a specific bug, you could take that image, build that VM, and you will be an exact copy of the environment that the client have. I know this video was a lot different than usual, less technical, but I needed to talk about the overview in the DevTest lab before going in details. In the next video, what I want to do is to show you how to create an ARM template that will define our full DevTest lab with the formula and the claimable VMs. So now that we are all comfortable with the Azure DevTest lab, I will be able to do that. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. Thank you for watching. See you next time. You can have more granularity. More granularity.